Everything goes away, Jack Sawyer, like the moon. Everything comes back, like the moon. You don't own a thing unless you can give it up. What does it profit a man? It profits him nothing. It profits him zilch. And you don't learn that in school. You learn it on the road. You learn it from Ferd Janklow and Wolf and Richard going headfirst into the rocks like a Titan II that didn't fire off right. Wolf! Right here and now. So, we've had our little discussion about the various villains in Stephen King's works. We've talked about Pennywise, the dancing clown, the monstrous shape-shifting horror from the 1,000 plus page novel It. We've also touched briefly on the nature of Leland Gaunt, the salesman from Needful Things, who turns out to be more than what he appears to be, and not in a good way. Then, last but not least, we discussed Randall Flagg, perhaps the ultimate villain in the works of Stephen King. Now though, it's time to discuss someone a little different. I think it's time we talked about someone who's a little less evil this time. Someone like a member of Stephen King's Losers Club. Possibly someone who could be their eighth member. Hi, hello, and welcome again, everybody, to another episode of Natural Juan. This time around, we're going to discuss Jack Sawyer, the hero of the novels The Talisman and Black House, written by both Stephen King and Peter Straub. Before all that, though, I'd like to invite you all to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell for notifications for more content like this. Here's a special shout-out, too, to Mr. Jonathan Green, my patron in Patreon. If you'd also like to support my channel and what I do here, then you can check out my Patreon information in the description below. If you'd just like to make a quick, one-time donation, I've also got both PayPal and GCash. Anyway, with all that out of the way, let's begin our journey. Jack Sawyer is a hero created by both Stephen King and Peter Straub. He appears in their novels The Talisman and Black House, where he plays the role of a primary protagonist. I would like to note that for many years since The Talisman was written, there has been a lot of discussion about turning it into a film, but to no avail. Apparently, even while big names like Steven Spielberg have been mentioned to be interested in making it work, it never comes to anything. I find that very sad since both The Talisman and Black House would have made for rather interesting films. To better understand Jack Sawyer, we will need to explore the first novel, which showcases the character's childhood and where he eventually learns to become a hero. In The Talisman, Jack Sawyer is just a young boy of about 12 and is seeking a way to heal his mother, Lily Sawyer, who is dying from sickness. Lily Sawyer was once a famous actress who played in numerous films, but is best remembered for her role as a heroine in a Western movie. Unfortunately, Lily Sawyer is on her deathbed and, to make matters worse, both she and Jack are on the run from Morgan Sloat, a former business partner of Jack's father, who is clearly up to no good. It is then, while wandering the streets, that Jack Sawyer first meets a friendly African-American man by the name of Speedy Parker. He learns from Speedy that nothing is as it seems, and that Jack's mother is actually a kind of extra-dimensional twin to a queen of a different dimension. Were Lily Sawyer to die at that point, the kingdom in that alternate dimension would be thrown into chaos and turmoil, and Morgan of Orris, Morgan Sloat's even more evil extra-dimensional counterpart, would rule with impunity. Thus begins Jack Sawyer's quest for the mythic Talisman, a supernatural artifact that could cure his mother of her illness and save that alternate dimension which Jack comes to call the Territories. On his way to find the strange artifact, Jack Sawyer meets and befriends many people and also encounters a lot of enemies along the way, both within this dimension and the Territories. Among those he befriends are a good werewolf who simply calls himself Wolf. A simple farmer who, while skeptical of his story, comes to understand the urgency of his quest, and Richard Sloat, the estranged son of Morgan Sloat, who finds a best friend in Jack Sawyer. There are also various monsters of both the supernatural and mundane kind that try to stop or hurt Jack, and these include a horrible shape-shifting goat creature, a greedy bar owner, and a mad preacher with a twisted view of Christian values. Now it's time to discuss the second half of the story, which is Black House, which takes place later on in Jack Sawyer's life. By then, he is a successful and retired homicide detective, choosing to live his middle age in the peacefully quiet town of French Landing in Wisconsin. He has very little memory of his adventures in the territories when he was 12, and is determined not to remember anything about them at all, even if his quest in that alternate dimension and his exposure to the mythic talisman continues to change him in the present day. However, all is not peaceful in French Landing, as a vicious serial killer who copycats the methods and name of the fisherman is on the prowl, kidnapping children and doing horrible things to them before eating parts of them. At first, Jack Sawyer is reluctant to assume the role of a homicide detective, as the killer is also associated with the powers that drove Jack on his quest when he was younger. This means that if he wants to locate and capture this copycat fisherman, he would have to resort to remembering the many blessings he received from the talisman all those years ago, and the supernatural events that came with them. That said, Jack Sawyer is eventually forced to remember his old self when the killer manages to kidnap Tyler Marshall, a boy with vast psychic power. This is when it is revealed that both the Talisman and Black House are related to the Dark Tower series by Stephen King, as Tyler is one of the children thought to have enough psychic power to bring down the Dark Tower, and with it, all creation. Jack Sawyer is then forced to call upon his supernatural powers once again in order to find this fisherman and hopefully rescue Tyler Marshall before the forces arrayed against the Dark Tower can have him. Standing in Jack Sawyer's way, though, is a place of great evil, simply known as Black House. It is the home of the child murderer that has taken up the title of the Fisherman, but that's not all. It has become a portal to a hellish dimension where lost and abandoned children are made to suffer until they die, and it is guarded by foul spirits and horrific monsters. While it's true that the killer built the more mundane parts of this house of horrors, it is very clearly empowered by evil forces, and those who stray too close fall under its supernatural influence. It will take nearly all of Jack Sawyer's supernatural power to just find this place of terrible darkness, and even more just to breach it. All in all, both books tend to contrast greatly with one another, with The Talisman displaying a more high fantasy feel, while Black House has a much darker tone that makes it qualify as out-and-out horror. This is understandable since, in The Talisman, Jack Sawyer begins his quest as a child and thus comes with the idealism that childhood brings. Meanwhile, Black House takes place in his middle age and, by then at least, Jack has already become an accomplished detective, having had to face the darker aspects of human nature, and had at least already managed to track down at least one serial killer. This means that through Jack Sawyer's eyes, the events of The Talisman were indeed a fantastical adventure of epic deeds, but as he had grown older and world-weary, he comes to see the more cynical side of life. That said, it's surprising that he manages to maintain the same sense of idealism he's always had in both books, and this is probably the reason he overcomes the forces that oppose him despite all odds. Well, that's it for this episode of Natural Juan. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please feel free to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell for notifications if you want to catch more content like this. If you'd also like to support my channel and what I do here, you can check out my Patreon information in the description below, which also comes with PayPal and Gcash info for making quick, one-time donations. Natural Juan,